Welcome back to SportsCenter. The brackets are in, the gambles have been taken, and now to discuss the odds, trends, and what makes a championship bracket, we have assembled a comprehensive panel for our centerpiece today. And here we go. We're going to start with sports betting expert RJ Bell of pregame.com and ESPN gambling expert Chad Millman. Guys, we've asked, would people, what would they do? Would they take the four seeds or the one seeds to win the tournament? Vegas cannot be biased because they actually take the bets, as we all know. So, RJ, what are they saying?
You're exactly right. You cannot afford to be biased if you're taking millions of dollars of bets like Vegas does. Four seeds are as good as we've ever seen them. But if you look at the mathematical odds, one seeds have a slightly better chance of winning than four seeds, though four seeds are mighty close. By the way, those four seeds have double the chance of the twos or the threes.
Chad, what do you think?
I think that this is a year where you kind of throw away what the numbers are saying because the four seeds are so much better than they have been. You think about Michigan State, you think about Louisville. Those are teams that a lot of people are thinking about as being great. They thought they might have been misseeded. I think there's a lot of animation and a lot of potential for what those teams can do. I think you got to think about those four seeds.
Now let's find out what our experts think and throw it over to David.
Yeah, Linda, we got ESPN Radio's Colin Cowherd and our College Hoops analyst, Seth Greenberg. Not a lot of people are talking Virginia, Wichita State to win it all, right? So
yes.
It seems like it breaks down. Do you like the Florida-Arizona combo, or do you like Michigan State-Louisville? Who would you take out of that bunch?
I like Michigan State across the board. I just think that they were misseeded. I mean, if you look at who they are now, it's interesting to me because the committee usually takes into consideration injuries. Who had more injuries than Michigan State? If you take the injuries and then you look at the way they were playing at the end of the season, when they had practice time, when they were whole, two different basketball teams. I like Louisville. My concern for Louisville is depending on how the game is officiated, if they get in foul trouble, they're in trouble. And, you know, I spoke to Tom Izzo this morning. He had his meeting with the officials. Yeah, every once in a while. But he said, and in those meetings, he said, just want to let you guys understand, we're going to try to call this game to the letter of the rule. And if they call it to the letter of the rule, you're going to see a lot of games decided by guys coming off the bench. I like Michigan State's bench.
I talked to the president of the United States this morning.
Very impressive. I like that. Well, you're Colin Cowherd.
Right? Anybody considered all these guys, RJ and Chad and the coach? It's harder to seed than ever before. Listen, the neighborhoods, everything's smushed into the middle. You don't get Patrick Ewing for 3 years. So the mid-majors are a little better. And the big schools get stars, but they leave early. I mean, I'm being told that Louisville outrageously is a four seed. They don't have a great lottery pick player. They lost to Memphis twice and lost to Cincinnati twice. First 12 games of the year, they only played one good team, Kentucky, and lost.
Who are the two veteran teams then?
Florida
and Michigan State.
But Michigan State's had injuries. And Florida, by the way, has got real bigs. What I like about them, they got a bunch of juniors and seniors. And Donovan has got a team it's an interesting team. I'm not sure he works with stars. He likes hungry guys. He grinds his players. So I kind of like Florida. But this idea that Louisville is wildly miscast, they lost to Memphis twice. They should have lost to Cincinnati twice.
I mean, everyone's got some
scars,
some losses. I mean, you play this many games, you're going to.
Right.
Would you take the four seeds or the one seeds, though? I ask you again. If you had, you can only take one.
Oh, I have to. See, they're getting marginalizing.
You have to.
I would take.
Don't qualify.
Well, I have Louisville
winning.
Let's
make a decision.
Well, I like Florida and I like Louisville. I would take the five favorites, though, over the field. Ask the Vegas guys about that. Ask Millman about that.
You're changing the question. Linda, back to you. What else you got?
That's so much fun. Okay, guys. Wichita State, perhaps the number one seed, getting the least respect in brackets. RJ, we'll start with you. What is Vegas saying about the potential Wichita State-Louisville matchup in the Sweet 16?
Yeah, once again, Louisville, a four seed, is projected to be the clear favorite over Wichita if they meet in the Sweet 16. And actually, Louisville is projected to be favored against any team in the Midwest. And some people here in Vegas believe that Louisville would be favored against any team in the country. So, yes, favored over Wichita. Yes, favored over the other Midwest teams. Yes, favored maybe over any team in the country. Louisville, actually, if you go back to the start of last season, has been favored in 71 of 72 games that they've played, including 43 straight. They opened up 15-1, Louisville did. They've been bet all the way down to 5-1. Bettors love them. They're the co-favorite right now.
Chad, are you buying what RJ is selling?
I'm buying what RJ's selling on Louisville. I agree that they are a team that everybody loves right now. It started with the bettors in the middle of the season. They were thinking Louisville is a team that from an offensive efficiency perspective, from a defensive efficiency perspective, those are what gamblers like. They were thinking Louisville has a good shot to be a number one seed. I also think that from a public perspective, we're talking about regular fans, you look at Tournament Challenge, the brackets we have, you got Florida, you got Michigan State, you got Louisville. Those are the three teams that everybody is thinking is going to make it to the finals.
For more on the lack of respect those Shockers are getting, let's send it back to David.
Yeah, I mean, this is a Final Four team from last year. They really have all their key personnel back, Van Vliet and Early and Baker. And yet, like I said earlier, no one is picking this team to make a deep run, even as deep as
you're a coach. You should like him, right?
I love Wichita State, and I don't have him going to the Final Four. No disrespect to Wichita State.
You don't have him going to the Sweet 16.
But it is disrespect.
I have Kentucky beating him in the third round.
What about experience and being
Look,
there?
I love their backcourt. I love their backcourt, and Cleon Anthony Early is a tough matchup. And you talk about Louisville, and you talk about their offense and defensive efficiency. That's a byproduct of who they played. The bottom half of the American, not very good. Wichita State is very good. My biggest concern is, can they rebound the ball? And again, I know their rebound numbers are good. It's great if you go to the analytics, but they haven't rebounded against Julius Randle. They haven't rebounded against the front court of Kentucky. And it's more, I think, Kentucky, the light bulb's gone on. To me, the light bulb, they're finally playing for the good of the group. You know, the start of the season, all the way up to about a month ago, those guys were playing for themselves. Whatever the tweak John Calipari did, these guys are now connected offensively and defensively. They're trusting each other. They're playing for the good of the group, and they're not quitting. You saw what happened in the SEC championship game. They could have folded their tents like they did at Florida, and they had the ball with a chance to win against a team all of us think is maybe the best team in the country, the overall number one seed. It's less about Wichita State. It's more about Florida.
See, but he goes big name. Over, you gave him all the analytics, and they're bringing people back. And I don't disrespect Wichita State, but they're going to lose to that 8 seed. Here's another
team. You think they're an 8 seed?
Yeah, that's what they are. By the way, Carolina. If Carolina wasn't called Carolina, they can't shoot. They can't shoot free throws.
True.
Roy Williams says, the only team I've ever had in 26 years of coaching, I'm petrified in big games. But everybody loves it. All of a sudden, everybody's like, oh, Carolina's playing. They don't have a single elite shooter. By the way,
I know you're talking to presidents big on Carolina.
I just think Wichita State gives you everything you want, but they're Wichita State. I think we're all nuts.
It's hard to get back to the Final Four two times in a row.
If Iowa State.
Butler did it, right?
Iowa State, if they wore North Carolina jerseys, wouldn't we have Iowa State in the Elite Eight? Iowa State gives you everything you want. But they're in A's.
They give you everything but a low post defender. Yes. Offensively, they're ridiculous.
Oh, he finds one thing.
Well, I'm just telling you. You tell me everything, everything.
Greg Marshall likes to say, we play angry. I think they're going to be playing angrier because they're not getting any respect whatsoever.
Nobody's picked them.
I think I'm rooting for Wichita State. That's our centerpiece today on odds and trends. And we got more. Back to Linda.
All right. Don't end it yet. We talked to teams. Now let's talk about the region that is known as the region of death. The Midwest, of course. Chad and RJ, you've spoken to odds makers and bettors. What are they saying about the Midwest, RJ?
Well, I tell you, multiple odds makers, bookmakers I talked to said this is the toughest region they have ever seen. Some of them tell me 4 of the top 10 teams in the country are in this region. And you know how you know for sure they're telling the truth? Every major team in this region, prior to the seedings, actually were downgraded once this Midwest region was set. So once they saw the kind of competition they had to face to make the Final Four, all the major teams' odds were downgraded. That was Vegas saying, you now have a tougher road, maybe the toughest we've ever seen.
What do you think, Chad?
I think that this is something that the gamblers in Vegas are just in shock over, because they are, at the end of the day, the gamblers in Vegas who follow college basketball, they're purists. They love good coaching. They love teams that play well together. They love Wichita State, and they are all convinced that the selection committee has a conspiracy against teams like Wichita State. They don't want those teams to advance. So I think that they're all thinking they built this bracket of death, this region of death, to get Wichita State out of the Final Four.
All right, David, send it back to Colin and Seth. What do they think about the Midwest?
Wichita State, best chance to get out of that bracket, that region. You guys buying that? Obviously, you're not.
I am not buying
it. Who do you take out of that region?
In the end, I take Duke. I like him offensively. Yeah,
small.
I like Duke. They're small, but they're playing Marshall Plumlee right now. Gives him a low post defender and a rim protector. Gives him a little bit of toughness. They got two lottery picks. I mean, you want to talk about odds? I'm going to take the team with two lottery picks.
You like coaches.
Yeah, I do.
You see Calipari, Izzo, phone calls. Do you pick coaches or players?
I want to talk to the president, though.
The president
hours.
Of Michigan State basketball. It seems like to me you lean on coaches a lot.
Well, I lean on coaches, matchups, and style of play. And I think that you got to be, in the end, yeah, the game starts in the with the guards, but you got to have guys who can make buckets. You got to have someone to play through at the end of a game. When you have a Rodney Hood and you got a Jabari Parker, you got two guys you can play through at the end of the game. And then you got a team that has improved as the season went along, because there was a stretch in the middle of the season, Duke was not playing well. Louisville concerns me because of their depth. I think if they blow the whistle tight, I really believe the officials are going to have an impact on the NCAA tournament this year because of the emphasis on the rules. If one guy gets in foul trouble, just forget about just regions. One guy gets in foul trouble in Arizona, they're done. Mm-hmm. All right. If Nick Johnson gets in foul trouble, they're playing with T.J. McConnell and Gabe York. Not going to win. I'm sorry. If one guy gets in foul trouble on certain teams, Louisville, if Montrezl Harrell gets in foul trouble, they're not winning because they have no other player up front that they can play through. So I look at it, well, Duke can survive foul trouble, and they got two definite, without a doubt, no question, lottery picks. What do you think of that, Kyle?
I have no courage. If I had courage, like Michael Smith, I'd take Iowa State, because I think Iowa State, no pressure, unbelievable coach, can shoot, can play different ways, but I don't have any courage, so I took Florida and Louisville.
You got Florida winning it?
I have Louisville winning it all, but I don't like it. I think it's all smushed in the middle. We haven't had a great team since that Duke team that had four NBA starters. There was a UConn team about a decade ago. There's no great team.
You said the key word, though, team. Florida is a team. Michigan State is a team.
Florida's got a lot of upperclassmen. They've been in this tournament.
Louisville, who you got?
Michigan State.
Michigan State. There you go. All right, Linda, one more time. Back to you guys.
Sounds like fun. All right, we've broken down the brackets a bit and the trends. Now tell us, guys, who you put your money on. RJ?
I agree with Colin. There is a lot of parity this year, but history tells us a four seed or better has won the tournament 25 straight years. 25 straight, a four seed or better. So my long shot is UCLA, but if I could only take one team, I'm taking Louisville.
Chad?
All right, so my final four, I've got Florida, Wisconsin, Michigan State, and Louisville. In the finals, I've got Michigan State and Wisconsin. I've got Michigan State winning.
All right. Chad Millman, RJ Bell, great insight. What a panel, what a SportsCenter centerpiece today. That was fun. Good luck, everybody.